So we realize that we need to study. We study the brain. We need to study the web. We don't really understand its complexity. And some of the people that we use that are doing really exciting work didn't have a community in which to share that and publish it. So we started talking about web science. And 3 years ago, we started as a web science research initiative and has now recently become the Web Science Trust in order to get people, academics, to think about it. And when we created the Web Science Trust, we had to think about what would be the objective of this thing. Well, we thought, okay, well, web science surely should be that the web should serve humanity to its utmost. Well, that actually made us stop and think. Because we realized that to get the web to serve humanity to its utmost, you need more than science. In fact, we realized that all the people who have been working on the standards and all the people who were the academics they knew that were working on the science were all part of a group who generally aimed at the early adopters. They're the people who had the smartphones, who were using the web. And when you talk about that the web should serve humanity, you immediately have to think about the other 80% of the world at the time who were not using the web at all. And so we thought more broadly. We realized that not only did we need the standards, not only do we need the science, but we also need to think of society in general. We need to think about society, the people who are less privileged, the people who, they may be poor, they may be in disconnected rural areas, or they may be poor in urban areas. They may be wealthy, but they may suffer from disabilities. They may be illiterate. And while connected, they're connected to a web which is very text-based. So, our conclusion was that we should create a World Wide Web Foundation to think about these things.